Okay, it's time to learn some more chords, and I've got four easy chords for you, so don't panic. Four easy chords. They are known as sus chords, and I'm talking about sus4, which you may have heard of, and also sus2, which maybe you've heard of, maybe you haven't. The sus, in case you didn't know, is an abbreviation of suspended, not sustained, it's suspended. What do you suspend? It's a bit of a misnomer. If I play a suspended fourth, you'd think, oh, so you suspend the fourth. No, it doesn't work like that. You suspend the third and put the fourth in its place. That's the way it works. So let's take a D chord, which you know, and suspend the third, as I was just explaining. Where's the third? Do, re, mi, the F sharp. We take it away, we suspend it. You hang it, you know, that's what suspending means, isn't it? And temporarily, replace it with the fourth. See, we don't say temporarily replaced, we say suspended. Sus4 is this, simply a D, but add your little finger on. The third has temporarily gone. Notice I'm saying it's temporary because you will typically go back to a D major, for example, Dsus4. And I trust you've noticed by now, I'm putting my little finger on. The D chord is there as a basis. I'm putting my little finger on the high G at the third fret of the top string. D major, Dsus4. And can you hear that it's not really at rest? It wants to go back to that. You can go back to minor, by the way. You can do D minor and Dsus4. A bit more of a melancholy mood. Dsus4, D minor. So either Dsus4, D major, Dsus4, D, or Dsus4, D minor. Why am I showing you pairs of chords? Well, the point is, as I'll be trying to make, sus chords typically take you somewhere and bring you back. They take you somewhere and bring you back. Okay, so a little detour. Sus2 is just as easy, if not easier to learn. Start with your D, for example. Take your second finger off. How hard was that? That is 1, 2. Guess what? It's a sus2 chord. And how hard was that? D major, Dsus2. And the good news, in case you haven't already discovered for yourself, noodling around, is that they all go together. D, Dsus4, Dsus2, in any order. You may wish to pause the DVD and just have a little noodle around. Okay, you've just learnt Dsus4 and Sus2. Let's apply the same mechanics, as it were, to A. So, unsurprisingly, start with A major, for example. The way that I recommended it. To be assertive, I'll remind you of the way I showed you back in chapter 1. Fingers 2, 3, and 4. The reason I chose that fingering, I'll reveal to you now. In fact, it's self-evident, I would say. You can just shift your little finger along for A sus4. 1, 2, 3, 4. There's the note of D, A, B, C sharp, D. So that's A sus4, simply shifting your little finger along. You can include the high open E if you wish. That's optional. So A major, A sus4, and guess what? You, as it happens, like the D chord, you take a finger off. It's not always that way, but in this case, you take this finger off to create A sus2. A sus2 is simply fingers 2 and 3, as they were in a normal A chord. The little finger has been taken away. A major, A sus4, A sus2, or indeed A minor, surrounded by A sus4, A sus2, A minor. That works nicely on electric, but perhaps you can imagine that on acoustic guitar, quite an atmospheric. I'm just picking the notes out amongst the chords there. Basically showing you chords that you already know. Brief recap there, A major, sus4, little finger along, little finger off. So you've got your top two strings open, A sus2. And of course you can mix them up with the D versions, Dsus4, Dsus2. You can do all that at your leisure. Remember, there are no rules when it comes to songwriting. There are ideas, there are concepts, but think the Lennon and McCartney way. In this new DVD, I'm not leaving anything to chance. I'm talking through all the little details. Without dwelling on the negative, I'm going to tell the viewer what might go wrong and point them in the right direction. As regards the techniques which the viewer will get from this particular DVD, bearing in mind that it's aimed squarely at absolute beginner, somebody that's just gone out and bought a guitar or maybe had one lying under the bed for however long, the basics, the fundamentals, such as finger picking, I'll be given a little finger picking primer in one of the chapters, one of the 10 chapters, along with some strict alternate picking, using a plectrum or flat pick, as the Americans say, strict alternate picking, for single note technique and strumming technique. You can apply the plectrum work to either of those. Also, a bit of a combination of those two things, pick plus fingers,